listeners, and welcome to part two of Action 52 for the Sega Genesis. And I'm recording this a little bit late, so that's why I'm whispering, but I'm kind of up close to the mic so you can hear me. So what was the first game again? The first game is Shark, and this game is absolutely stupid, basically, because it's literally just like an underwater like shooting game, and all you do is wait for the sharks to come, and they take an absolute long time to come. So when they actually do get there, they're kind of hard to kill, and it's kind of repetitive anyway. So the gameplay on this game really isn't that good, so we're gonna go ahead and move on from shark. Isn't a good game. And then what's the next game? The next game we're looking at is Knockout, and as you can see by its blue color, it's a two-player game. But this game really isn't fun, even if it was two players. 16-bit boxers, in my opinion, don't really work. For a box game to be fun, it kind of has to be 3D. It's kind of just stuck that way. Not saying 2D ones aren't good. There's some good 2D ones. But lots of times, they're just not good, and this is one of them. Even if maybe with the second player, it could be okay. This is considered one of the more decent games in Action 52 for the Sega Genesis. All you do is walk up, hit your enemy, and it's two-player only. So if you don't have a second player, it's not even worth playing, so you can skip right of it and you can count that out. But we're gonna go ahead and move on from this game. All around, takes a couple hits to knock your opponent out. Once you get them knocked out, you go on about your day. Like the characters really aren't that good, so we're gonna go ahead and go on to the next thing. And the next thing would be Intruder, right? Yeah, Intruder is trash, like straight up. I'm being just honest with you. Intruder is straight up trash. It's garbage. Literally, the only thing you do is stand. If you move and you touch the red parts, you die. But this is the only screen. I thought it was going to be like a maze type game, but it didn't turn out to be that way. Instead, it just turned out to be this, and this is not fun. If you touch the red parts, you die. If you're stuck here in this little section until the enemies come. Well, if you get touched by them, you die. You're just stuck here in an infinite loop shooting to kill them. The game isn't fun, so we're gonna go ahead and move on to the next one. And also, I want to mention you can see the color code there for what each game is. So after Intruder, we move on to Echo. Hey, this is still the week of Echo, everybody. But spelled and not the Italian words. But anyway, this game is just Simon, kinda. You just do what the pattern was. You just remember the pattern, and that's all you do. If you mess up, it restarts, and that's literally it. This game has nothing more to it than that. And in a second here, we're gonna go ahead and move on from this. But yeah, this game has nothing more to it than that. There's some echo. This is, I was expecting dolphins, sonars, and creepy music. But anyway, on to the next thing. And the next thing is Freeway. And Freeway is just a straight up Frogger clone. It doesn't even bother to hide it, but it is a little bit weirder because in this game, when you go over, you also have to come back. So you have to go over, touch the spots, and then come all the way back across the road and do it again. So yeah, this game really isn't a fun game. It's a very weird in its execution. See, you go over, I collected the two things, almost collected the two things. I didn't notice that I collected one of them, but you gotta go over, collect them both, and bring them back. That's all you do. And this game is pretty gruesome in the fact that in the way it kills the dog, which it might turn some people off. Look, you can see blood, you can see his head literally get decapitated. So this game is pretty gruesome in that regards. Action 52 is just the weirdest collection in the first place. So I'm gonna go ahead and move on from Freeway to Mousetrap. I literally clicked Freeway again by accident. I'm sorry about that. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and move on to Mousetrap. Which Mousetrap is a weird one, and yes, I'm voicing this over. Mousetrap is a weird one because you just collect the cheese and avoid the tigers. Now, the pattern you're going to start to see, especially on the second page, is a lot of these games start to become rehashes of the same game. Now, I want you to see that, pay attention to the space background of the Action 52. As you can see the space background back there, I want you to pay attention to that because that's going to come up later. So next we're moving on to Ninja, and first off, I'm pretty sure Tyler, the guy who plays that Fortnite YouTuber, Ninja, whatever his name is, I'm pretty sure he's probably going to get mad at this and try and sue this game once he sees this. But nah, I'm just joking since they were out way before him. But either way, there has to be a couple movies called Ninjas. I know three Ninjas and a couple more other movies. But just to be called Ninja, I thought that would have been copyrighted or something like that. But no, it's not. Anyway, this game is boring. You literally just walk over and just throw shurikens. That is literally what you continue. continue to do. The scenery doesn't change, the music doesn't change, and I sat here and I thought the level never ended, and I just thought it was an endless runner. Lots of times the enemies won't even come after you, so it's not even a fun game in that regard, but then other times they will come after you and come get you. But it's very weird, and I just recommend you don't even play this one. Don't play this game at all. But as you can see, I move on to level 2 here, and sometimes the ninjas show up, sometimes they don't. Sometimes you make it to level 2, sometimes you don't. The game is just very weird in that regard, and it gets to a point where the ninjas, the red ninjas, who are the bad guys, they don't even hurt you anymore. Literally, they just run off screen. You can still kill them if you want to, but all in all, not a fun game. Wouldn't recommend it. So next we're going to move on to Salon. Yeah, this one is weird because it's called Salon, right? But I thought it was going to be like a hairdressing game, but nope, it's a skiing game. So maybe skiing is called Salon somewhere else. I don't really know, but that's what it's called. I make it to level two in this game, but yeah, literally it's just an avoid the tree game and keep on going about your day. That's all you do. The game is pretty simple. It's pretty easy. Not fun. Just don't play it. Like I said, don't even play this collection. Like, I still feel bad for any kid who went out and brought this game or got this game for Christmas because they thought they were going to be able to have 52 games to play all year round. No siree. So after Salon, we move on to Dauntless. And Dauntless is... what is Dauntless again? Come on, mate. Click Dauntless. Dauntless was... oh yeah, Dauntless was that World War II shooter. That's right. So Dauntless, now this one is actually pretty cool. And the only reason this one, I praise this one for being cool is, first off, history buff. So, well, way nice call out to World War II. Second off, I really like the clouds effect here. For the be a Sega Genesis game, the clouds effect here is actually pretty nice. And the music was actually pretty okay here. Although you can't hear it. You're going to hear one of the random Action 52 songs in the background. But the music was pretty okay here. And it was okay for what it was. It wasn't bad, it wasn't good. But as we get further into this, I want you to, like I said, pay attention to the space background that's back here. Now as we get into Fierce One, look at this. They rehashed the space background from the first part of the game, from the menu of the game, and you're gonna see this a couple more times in this video, so pay attention. Keep looking for the space background because they just sorry for the little audio cut there, but yeah, you're gonna see a common trend here soon enough of the games rehashing what was already here. You're gonna see that soon enough. That's gonna continue to happen, so just keep your eye out for that space background again. And the next game after Force One was Spidey, and I accidentally clicked Force One again just to verify that there actually was it actually was, and I keep clicking Gold Bunkers. I've clicked Force One again to verify that it actually was the space background, but yeah, they keep reusing it. Now we move on to Spidey, and this is another example of rehashing. That Spidey is literally just Mousetrap. Literally, they just rehashed Mousetrap, made it a spider, changed the graphics, and called it a day. So don't even... if you've played Mousetrap, you've played Spidey too. So next we move on to, what was the game, next game called Appleseed. So Appleseed is literally a common game. It's literally just run from side to side, collect the red apples in your basket, and don't let the green apples fall into your basket. But this one is a little bit weird because apples are very small and they move very fast and they're very hard to see. So sometimes you can mistake a green apple for red apples and green apples and red apples for green apples, so you miss apples. But we're gonna move on from that and we're gonna move on to Skater. Now Skater, if you've ever played other skating games on the Sega Genesis or even other consoles, they're pretty fun. This game is not fun. The music here is literally ear bleeding. It will literally make your ears bleed. I was done with Skater after dying one time just because I've seen everything it had to offer. So we're going to move on from Skater, and after Skater we get Sunday Drive, and Sunday Drive is pretty weird. Funny how this video has gone up on a Sunday and we're playing a game called Sunday Drive. Let's move on from that. Sunday Drive is literally just drive across the road, dodging the cars. There's the gameplay. There's no level 2s, there's no none of that. There is a level 2, but I just reset the game after that and called it a day. So remember, this space background is going to come up again in Star Evil, which is a weird name, by the way. As you can see, they rehashed the space background again. Yup, and it's very easy to die here. This game is very unnecessarily hard and not even a good game in the first place. Also, how does blood come out of your spaceship? Just how does that even happen now? Things are just getting ridiculous here, but yeah, this game has an unnecessarily difficulty, and it's literally just another shooting game, which there's abundance of good ones on Sega Genesis, so why would you even touch that? But after Star Evil, we're gonna go ahead and move on to Air Command. Now, Air Command is another one of these games, another one of these types of games. You'll see what I mean here. It's another one of these shooter games, but this time you move down instead of up, which is actually kind of a little bit weird because I was expecting to move up and not down. But yeah, it's boring, unoriginal, the graphics aren't good, and the music is terrible. Now we can go ahead and move on to the next, which is another example of rehashes. Like I said, a lot of these games, they just switch the graphics. Of another game and call it a day. Like, there was that, remember, if you remember from part one, we had that Western game. Well, Shootout, which is this next one, is literally just that. It's literally just a Western game, but rehashed to have ducks and stuff in it, and they removed the cursor so you can only shoot out once, so you can only shoot up one way. This game is weird, it sucks, it's not fun, it's unintuitive. I don't even know what it is. We can move on to the next one now. And the final one for page 2 and part 2, and the next one is going to be Bombs Away, so that if I can get over to it. So the next one is Bombs Away. We're here at Bombs Away, and this one is a little bit weird because you're just running away from bombs. That's literally it. There's nothing more. The scenery never changes. This looks like an 8-bit scenery, not even a 16-bit one. The music here is ear screeching again. The gameplay sucks. You dodge bombs, and if you stay in the back, they won't even really come for you. You can literally not move and never get hit. But anyway, that's gonna go ahead and do it for this video. Action 52, we're gonna move on to the last page tomorrow, which is Monday, to end this series off. So part 3 of Action 52 will be tomorrow, and we're gonna be moving on to the last page, which is the green page and the white page. I also want you to note something. There's this game called First Game, and I can't wait to show you what that is tomorrow. But anyway, that's really gonna do it for this video. If you're new, if you could subscribe, that would be awesome. I've been the world's coolest Sega enthusiast, Sega Sir 64, and until next time,
have a good one, Slayers.